Hello students and welcome to Brilliant's online EDU classes. I am here with a very important topic of grammar, that is modal verbs, usually known as modals. We have to learn the right use of modal verbs as we express some expressions on daily basis. And to denote the expressions, we go on using some special modal verbs in our sentences. Therefore, we have to learn how to use a proper modal verb to express a particular expression or feeling. Here, see the examples. My son is sick. I should see a doctor. Here, the sentence denotes requirement or the duty of a mother for her son. May I help you? Here, it's a polite request or proposal that may I help you or not. I am below 18 years. I must not drive. Here, the sentence denotes the sense of prohibition that the one who is below 18 years is strictly forbidden to drive. You should not pluck flowers. It's like an advice that you should not pluck flowers. We ought to save our Mother Earth. It means it is our moral duty to save our earth. Now, see these examples. I can sing melodious songs, the sense of ability. I must save water. It means it's necessary to save water. My hands are dirty. I must wash it. Yes, it means it's compulsory to wash hands. Without washing hands, nothing can be done. You cannot eat. You have to wash your hands at any cost. We need to save power. The sentence denotes the need of saving power. The sentence denotes necessity of saving power. Today is Ram's birthday. May God bless him. Here, the sentence denotes blessing. I used to fly kites when I was young. The sentence denotes a past habit, a habit that existed in past. So what do we learn? Having seen such examples, the modal verb may is used to denote wish. May I be successful? It is used to denote polite request. May I come in, ma'am? The modal verb may is used to denote possibility. It may rain today. And may is also used to denote blessings. May you live long. May he be successful, etc. Might denotes weak possibility. If we say it may rain today, it means there is possibility to rain today. But if we say it might rain today, now the modal verb might denotes the weaker possibility than the previous one. Can is used to denote power, capacity, ability, probability, request. He can lift the heavy box. It denotes power. The glutton can eat 40 breads. The glutton can eat 40 breads. This sentence denotes capacity. He can qualify the UPSC exam. This is ability. The weak students can qualify the exam now. It's probability. Can I use your pen? It is request. Shall is used to denote permission or future plan. We shall go to Patna next year. Should is used to advise. It seems you are not well. You should consult a doctor and then you should take proper medicine. Could is used to denote past ability. She could recite Ramayana spontaneously when she was 5 years old. And could is also used to denote formal and very, very polite request. Could you please help me? Could you send the file, please? Will is used to denote certainty. Will is used to denote future tense, future predictions, future probability. I will go there. It will be raining in the month of August. Would is used to denote wish and polite request. Would you like to have a cup of tea? Must. Must is used to denote advice, necessity, compulsion. You must attend classes regularly. You must complete your homeworks in time. You must complete all your activities in time. Must not or mustn't denotes prohibition. You must not go there. That place is dangerous. Ought to. Ought to is used to denote moral duty, obligation. You ought to serve your parents. You ought to serve the country. used to denotes past habit. I used to fly kites when I was a child. Dare is used to denote courage. I dare to go into the haunted palace. Dare not. Dare not denotes the sense of fear. I dare not go into the haunted palace. Need denotes necessity. I need to take medicine. I need to consult a doctor as I am not well. Need not denotes something that is not required. You need not go there. That place is not for you. Now, let us know about marginal verbs, marginal models, marginals or marginal model auxiliaries. Actually, there are three marginals or three marginal models. Dare, need and used to. These three models are used in the sentence as model verbs and as main verbs. Dare and need are used as a normal finite verb in affirmative sentences like I dare to go there. He dares to go there. I need to take medicine. I don't need to take medicine. He needs to take medicine or he does not need to take medicine. Actually, in affirmative sentences, dare and need both are always used as a normal finite verb. But these two verbs can be used as model verbs also in interrogative or negative sentences. Students, listen to me carefully. Only in interrogative and negative sentences, dare and need can be used as model verbs. But in interrogative and negative sentences, both the verbs can be used normal finite verbs also. Like, do I dare to go there? Here, dare has been used as normal finite verb. But if we say, dare I go there? Here, dare has been used as a model verb. I don't dare to go there. Here also, the word dare has become a normal finite verb. But if we use in this way, like, I dare not go there. Now, in this sentence, the verb dare has become a model verb. You can notice here, whenever dare becomes a model verb, bare infinitive is used in the sentence. There is no to with the verb go whenever dare has become model. Dare I go there? I dare not go there. To is not used with the verb whenever dare and need become model verb in the sentence. It means we have to use bare infinitive in the sentence whenever we have to use dare and need as model verb. But mind it carefully, only in negative and interrogative sentences. All these concepts are not only about dare but also about need. Used to. Here you can see the negative sentence has been made, I did not used to watch movies. Like a normal finite verb, like a normal past tense. But it can be used as a model verb also. Like, I used not to watch movies. Did I used to watch movies? In the very same way, in interrogative sentences also. Like, did I used to watch movies? A normal finite verb. But as a model verb, it is used like, used I to watch movies. So, in negative and in interrogative sentences, used to can be used as model verb also. These are some examples of model verbs. Dear students, go through the examples properly. So having seen the examples of models, we can say that model verbs are auxiliary verbs. Model verbs add meaning to the main verbs. Model verbs express mode or manner of the actions denoted to the main verb. Thank you, students.